So, jo Freunde, herzlich willkommen zu einem neuen Video hier auf meinem Kanal. Wie jeden Morgen schauen wir uns auch heute wieder gemeinsam den neuen Fortnite-Job an, wo sich wieder beide Seiten geupdatet haben. Wir haben wieder so dieses Himmel- und Hölle-Thema auf der linken Seite und auf der rechten haben wir auch noch einen neuen Emote und zwar den Zusammenreißer für 200 V-Bucks. Den werde ich euch gleich zeigen. Fangen wir erstmal auf der linken Seite an und zwar mit dem ziemlich geilen Sakria-Skin, beziehungsweise finde ich die Flügel ziemlich krass, also die schauen ziemlich mächtig aus. Die Hacke, ohne erst die Lackierung, die finde ich jetzt okay, würde ich sagen. Sie ist halt leicht animiert. Also die Animation ist wirklich nicht krass. Ihr seht es hier so, dieses weiß schimmernde zieht so über die Waffe drüber. Ist in Ordnung, würde ich sagen. Aber jetzt auch keine spektakuläre Lackierung. Die Hacke finde ich eigentlich auch ganz cool. Ich überlege sogar, sie mir vielleicht gleich zu kaufen. Vor allem wegen diesen Lichteffekten. Das ist übrigens der Sound. Wie komisch. Der Schwung hört sich so mega heftig an. Und dann kommt nur so ein kleines... Pling. Mal gucken, vielleicht hole ich mir die gleich noch. Genau, das wäre erstmal das erste Set und jetzt noch das zweite. Da sind nur zwei Items drin. Einmal der Melkor, auch mit ziemlich coolen Flügeln auf dem Rücken. So eine Art Teufel. Und dann noch der böse Blick mit so einem Auge, was so richtig creepy schaut. Und auch hier wieder so, ja, Feuereffekten und dem Sound. Okay, das hört sich wirklich episch an, kostet natürlich auch einiges, aber ich würde sagen, das ist auf jeden Fall eine ziemlich coole Hacke, die kann ich auf jeden Fall empfehlen. Kommen wir dann auch schon zur rechten Seite, wie immer lasst doch gerne einen Daumen nach oben da, ihr seid gestern vollkommen eskaliert, habt irgendwie 5400 Likes oder so gedroppt, deswegen vielen Dank für die ganzen Daumen nach oben. Und da kommen wir jetzt schon zum ersten Slot und zwar zum Dämonenschädel, passt eigentlich ganz gut zum Melkor hier, auch wenn er aus einem anderen Set kommt, aber diese Lava-Kleckse nenne ich es mal, die schaut echt ganz cool aus, dass sie so runterdroppen auch in-game. Und dann hören wir uns mal ganz kurz den Sound an. Okay, der ist jetzt nicht so krass, aber schaut natürlich ein bisschen heftiger und böser aus als die andere Hacke, aber dafür ist der Sound halt leider nicht so heftig. Ich finde, für 1200 V-Bucks sollte eine Hacke schon so einen einzigartigen, coolen Sound haben und nicht so standardmäßig, sage ich mal. Dann haben wir noch den Libre-Gleiter, eigentlich recht preiswert, obwohl ich sagen muss, dass ich den Rahmengleiter, der relativ ähnlich ausschaut, nur halt in lila, nochmal ein kleines bisschen cooler finde. Dann haben wir noch die Dschungelspeerin. Ich würde sagen, das ist ein ziemlich guter Skin, wenn man ein bisschen tryhard möchte, nicht weil das jetzt so ein Tryhard-Skin ist, sondern weil man damit eigentlich ja ganz gut getarnt ist. Also die Farben von dem Skin sind schön unauffällig. Braun und grün passen eigentlich immer ganz gut in die Landschaft. Man fällt also relativ wenig auf, ganz gut getarnt in der Landschaft. Dann haben wir noch die Zündkerzenkünstlerin. Den Skin finde ich ganz cool, den Backpack finde ich ein bisschen unnötig. Also keine Ahnung, den habe ich, glaube ich, kein einziges Mal bisher gespielt. Den Schrottbello, so ein komischer Hund aus Schrott. Aber der Skin ist auf jeden Fall ziemlich cool. Der hätte auch deutlich teurer sein können. Dann haben wir noch den Emote Träumerfüße. Ja, der gefällt mir richtig gut. Ich mag die Musik, ich mag die Moves. Also für den hätte ich auch locker 800 V-Bucks ausgegeben. Kann ich also absolut empfehlen. Und dann haben wir noch im letzten Slot des heutigen Tages den neuen Emote. Das ist quasi Highlight, wenn man so will. Den Zusammenreißer. Ja, und das war's schon. Also das ist wirklich der lameste Emote, den ich bestimmt seit einem Jahr gesehen habe. Ich spiele ihn gerne nochmal ab. Also, ich weiß nicht, wann soll man den Emote denn bitte verwenden? Mir fällt jetzt wirklich kein sinnvoller Grund ein, warum ich den Emote abspielen würde. Ja, da gibt es eigentlich für alle solche ähnlichen Situationen einen cooleren Emote. Deswegen würde ich wahrscheinlich an eurer Stelle lieber nicht die 200 V-Bucks hier ausgeben. Ich würde wahrscheinlich den Emote nicht mehr nehmen, wenn ich dafür 200 V-Bucks bekommen würde. Aber, nein, Spaß beiseite. Aber ich werde ihn mir leider holen, oder was heißt leider, aber ich werde ihn mir halt holen, weil ich natürlich euch dann jetzt im nächsten Video machen will, wo ich euch alle Emotes zeige, die es in Fortnite gibt, weil ich halt alle aktuell habe, die es so gibt im Spiel. Ich habe so viele Emotes. Die werde ich euch dann alle mal nacheinander zeigen und deswegen werde ich mir den halt jetzt holen. Aber, Leute... Ich würde ihn nicht empfehlen, ich würde ihn wirklich nicht empfehlen. Könnt mir gerne mal in die Kommentare schreiben, wie ihr den findet. Und ihr könnt auch gerne ein Abo da lassen, falls ihr natürlich neu seid und hier noch nicht abonniert habt. Ich zeige euch wirklich jeden Morgen den neuen Fortnite-Shop, egal ob er halt gut ist oder schlecht ist oder halt wenn was Neues drin ist. Jeden Morgen zeige ich euch, was Neues in den Shop reinkommt. Deswegen, falls ihr neu seid, lasst sehr gerne ein Abo da. Und falls ihr schon abonniert habt, dann aktiviert die Glocke. Einfach mal kurz runter scrollen und dieses kleine Glockensymbol anklicken, damit ihr morgens mal eine Benachrichtigung bekommt, was halt Neues im Shop drin ist. Ja, ansonsten hoffe ich, das Video hat euch gefallen. Ich wünsche euch einen guten Start in die Woche. Und wenn ihr mich nachher noch supporten wollt, ihr seid in Fortnite zufällig online, dann, guck mal, trag gerne dort Snoxy ein. Muss ich mal wieder machen. Also, ja, trag gerne Snoxy dort als Creator ein, wenn ihr mich unterstützen wollt. Und dann habt noch einen entspannten Tag. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Haut rein. Tschüss.
What's going on, YouTube? My name is iTalk. I knocked out his teeth and I ripped out his heart. Here and in today's video, we have another video. And in today's video, we get to rant about the item shop again. Oh man, I'm tired of talking about how the item shop needs an update, but I wanted to just go more in depth with why I feel so passionate about this item shop rant, because there's a few things I need to discuss about it. But before I even get into that, if you guys are unaware somehow, the item shop is a feature in Fortnite where every 24 hours it resets and we get new skins, new outfits, which is what they're called. They're called outfits, gliders, harvesting tools, emotes, wraps, music, all this stuff. We have a ton of stuff in the item shop rotation, as they would say. And from what I'm aware, the item shop is made 1 week in advance, and there is an item shop rotation, but not every single item is in the rotation. So when they decide to bring something back, like let's just say the power cord skin, for example, if it sells well, they'll keep it in the item shop rotation, and they'll manually put in stuff to bring back every so often. Like recently, we got the triple threat and the jump shot skin set back, and that was not in rotation. So what I think they did was they just plopped it into the rotation if it did sell well, and in about a month's time we'll probably see it again. That's just how I've envisioned the item shop to work. Now there's a lot of issues with the item shop, and I want to just get all of my ideas out right now in this one video, and I really don't want to talk about my frustrations with the item shop anymore, because from what I can tell, the item shop to me is a special occasion. It sounds weird, I know, but I love the item shop. I've been recording the item shop changing over since October of last year, which isn't super long, but I've been doing it for a decent amount, I would say, and I've loved it. Every single day I am home and I am recording for the item shop every single day, and I love it. It's a great experience. You never know what you could get. You could get something really cool. But most of the time, and I'm not going to lie to you, and I'm not trying to be negative here, but most of the time, it's very disappointing. And I feel like the item shop needs a lot more changes to it than meets the eye. So let me just get into every single thing that they need to do with the item shop, in my opinion, at least. Number one, you have to make the item shop bigger. This is like a must-have, because they have so many skins and everything now, and there's more coming into the game every single day. You keep using the same interface of the item shop and expect to make more sales. You really cannot do that. So I went ahead and I counted every single item that is in the item shop. Every single one, not including battle pass, not including challenges, all item shop related things. So for item shop emotes, we have 153. We have 114 gliders, we have 3 music tracks, we have 42 legendary skins, we have 132 epic skins, we have 88 rare skins, not including Aerial Assault Trooper and Renegade Raider because those are Season Shop, and 48 uncommon skins. In total, we have 310 item shop outfits slash skins. We also got one pet, which was the Empress pet, and we have 157 pickaxes and 34 wraps. 772 items are in the item shop. That is how many items that we have in the item shop, and half of them never see the light of day, because it's always with the same old that we get every single time in the item shop. We always see one of those items that just comes back way too often, and that's why I complain about items coming back too often, because you have all of these items in your inventory. You have all these skins, all these harvesting tools, all these gliders, and they do nothing with them. If they want more sales, they need to expand the shop. They need to sell more unique items instead of just the same old, because that's not how you get sales. You get sales by putting in stuff that isn't out very often, and you get more sales by putting in stuff that brings more hype to the game. Like Ghoul Trooper is the most hyped up skin right now, and I don't even know if we're getting it for Halloween. But the thing is that, like, the reason why I'm so passionate about this is because I'm a skin collector. I like collecting all the skins in Fortnite. I like collecting all the wraps. I like collecting all the emotes, and that's about it. I don't collect every single pickaxe and glider. But what I'm trying to say is that, like, when I see them bringing back the same old stuff every single day, I understand they have to do it sometimes because they just have to have a bad shop every once in a while. But when it's the majority of your shops, that's when it's a bad thing. The second thing I wanted to discuss here is that the item shops are way too spaced out. So they did make a little bit of space. They now typically have 3 featured slots instead of 2 now. However, it hasn't really changed much of anything, and I'm going to go over to it right now as to why. So I have quite a few examples here. So for the first example here, we have the Daring Duelist and the Hang Time Bundle and all that. This is actually today's shop right here. So we have Daring Duelist, that's fine. You have the Hang Time Bundle, right? So first of all, the Hang Time Bundle was accessible through challenges. You didn't even need to put in the item shop, so that's a small issue there. Also, Flex Holem and Buckets are part of the same set as Hang Time Bundle. These two easily should have been with the featured items, so you have 2 slots saved up for daily items that you could have put anything else in, but you decided to put these two separate from the Hang Time Bundle. And don't give me like, oh, they don't have enough space. Here's another proof right here. The soccer skins right here you see in the 3rd featured slot, you see that they have 11 things in the featured. They can easily do this. There is absolutely no excuse for them to not stack certain things together. If it's in the same set, it should be stacked that way. So in the featured items, it should have been the Daring Duelist set, which it is, the Hang Time Bundle with these 2 emotes. And then these 2 emote slots should have been something else. They could have done anything else besides these 2 items, but yet they did it anyway, and they couldn't have just put it with the featured items with the Hang Time Bundle because they put in the Hang Time Bundle. Now, if they didn't put in the Hang Time Bundle, I wouldn't really care because, yeah, it's the last day that these 2 emotes will probably be out for a good while, so I'm not really upset about that. But the fact that they put the Hang Time Bundle in the featured items, these 2 easily should have been with the Hang Time Bundle. That's all I'm saying. And also, as I'm recording this video, Flying Carp was last out like 9 days ago, which is also unacceptable. You have over 700 items in the shop, and yet you still bring back the same old stuff from 9 days ago. This needs to change because it's making your shops a lot more boring and a lot less interesting. Here's another one. Here's when we got the Jump Shot and Triple Threat back. Here's the issue. You have Jump Shot, Triple Threat, the Slam Dunk Harvesting Tool, and the Hang Time Glider. All 3 of these are taking up 3 featured slots. Why? Why is this a thing? And also you have the baller emote in daily. Why do you have it there? Why is it not with the set? So here's my issue again. You have all these, you have 4 spaces taken up by the same set. This is a problem. They need to make it so Jump Shot, Triple Threat, the whole set is together. So that way you have 2 more featured item slots. I'm dead convinced they just don't know what to put in the shop. And that's why I want a poll system for us to be like, oh, hey, we want Recon Expert back because we're tired of toxic YouTubers abusing the skin. Oh, wait, we want, I don't know, Ghoul Trooper back or something. There needs to be something to excite the community with the item shop. I mean, it's every day. You'd think that they wouldn't be doing stuff like this. So here's another example here. We have the soccer skins returning. This was actually yesterday's shop as I'm recording this video. So you have the Takara set. That's fine. Then you have the soccer skins. Then you have the 2 harvesting tools and the glider. And then you have the 2 emotes in the daily. This is a problem. Why is this not together? Why is the soccer skins not with the 2 harvesting tools and the glider and the 2 emotes? Why is it separated like this? This takes up more space and it's unnecessary when, like I said, you have over 700 items you could easily put in the item shop, but you choose not to for some reason, and it's very annoying. So easily you could add 2 daily slots and you could have 1 whole featured slot. And then the last example I have here, it's a small one, but here's the thing right here. In daily items, you have Abstract and Renegade Roller. They're part of the same set. Why on earth are they separated? I really don't understand this at all. And also, I'm kind of tired of seeing Dynamo in the shop, which is actually a good transition to the other thing I wanted to talk about. Some of the item shop items you have come out way too often. Like I said, 772 items you have in your arsenal to put in the item shop for us to purchase, but yet you don't utilize them and you only give us Dynamo, Light Show, Nightlight. You give us all of these terrible skins that we see so often, but yet you don't put in the other items. Why? Why don't you do that? It's so frustrating. That's why I'm so I get so annoyed when I say, oh, I see it too often, so it's automatically a bad shop. But you choose to bring out Moniker over and over again, even though it has been a little bit since it was last out. You decide decide not to bring it. You keep bringing out Dynamo. You keep bringing out Nightlight, Light Show, Fate, Omen. You bring out the same stuff all the time, but you don't diversify it. Why do you not diversify the item shop, Epic? Why do you not do it? Do you want more sales? Do you want to make more money? Because the way the shops have been for the past few months, honestly, have been stale, have been boring, have been the same old, oh, are we gonna get Dynamo today? Oh, I bet we're gonna get Moniker today. Oh, I bet we're gonna get the Light Show again, the Nightlight. We're gonna get the same old, the Scorpion, the Armadillo. We're gonna get every single skin that we have seen in the shop so many times. We're gonna be getting that today. We're not gonna get anything new. We're not gonna get anything interesting. The only interesting shop we've had in a while was Jumpshot and Triple Threat coming back. Okay, and that was it. Since then, there really hasn't been anything super crazy in the past few months, honestly. So again, it just frustrates me. You have so much potential to make really good item shops, and you have a lot of potential to make a lot of good sales. But again, you don't do it. Moisty Merman, Leviathan. Leviathan finally came back after someone at Epic decided, oh wait, Leviathan hasn't been out in a while. And like Moisty Merman, like they're forgetting about the old skins that made the game what it is today, the Season 4 skins. They forgot about all of that. And I'm just frustrated with how they've been handling the item shop. And I'm not even done yet. I'm not even done with my ranting yet. So here's another one. Some sets never come out together. So the perfect example, Bandolier. Bandolier is a skin that has not been in the shop for over
173
days. But yet we have the Bandolette skin, which is in the same set as Bandolier. And that came out like four times in the span of the amount of days that Bandolier hasn't been out. Why aren't they putting Bandolier with the Bandolier set? Why are they flat out ignoring it? I know for a fact they haven't forgotten about the skin. At least I hope they don't. And here's the other huge example, the Love Ranger skin. We used to see the skin once a month, and it was very annoying. I will admit it was very annoying. Now we haven't seen him in almost half a year. Why? Because whenever they put in Cuddle Team Leader, which again is almost once a month at this point, maybe it might be once every 45 days now, but the Cuddle Team Leader has now taken over. They gave her a harvesting tool, they gave her a glider, and now every time they bring that out, Love Ranger is nowhere to be found. Why? I don't know. It's part of the same set. You would assume that it would be together, but it's not. Why? Why? Do you not want more sales, Epic? Just put more skins in the shop. Make it bigger. Do something. They're so... You know what? Honestly, I wish I could do the item shop rotation. I would know what to put in the shop. I would listen to community feedback. I'd be like, okay, put this in. Don't put this in. I hate that I have to say this, but like, I've just gotten so annoyed with the shops as of late. It is absolutely infuriating that they don't take advantage of their item shops. Again, they could make so much more money if they stop putting in the same old crap every single time. And the last thing I'm going to say is that there needs to be a poll or something. They need to bring hype somehow. And with these shops and how bad they've been, I'm just overall frustrated with, you know, getting hyped up for the item shop, because that's what I do. I love the item shop. I'm like, oh yeah, we get to do the item shop today. Oh, I can't wait to see what's in the shop. And then I just end up getting disappointed because it's always the same old stuff. And I'm just, they have the skins, they have the emotes. Why are half the green emotes not being sold in the item shop? Half of these emotes haven't been in the shop in over 100 days. That's a problem. This is just bizarre to me, and I don't know what they're doing, and I really hope that someone at Epic listens to me or something, because I've been on Reddit. Every time Light Show comes back, they all meme it up. They're like, oh my god, I missed Light Show. I'm glad I could finally buy it. Something needs to change with the item shop, and I hope they take this criticism to heart. This is not hate. I love Epic Games. I love the Fortnite item shop. I really do, but I want to see some changes, and I think you guys do too. So thank you guys so much for watching the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, let me know with a like, but only if you enjoyed my content. Subscribe to the channel if you're brand new, and turn on the bell just to get all my latest uploads, and comment down below. Are you happy with how the item shops have been as of late? I would love to know. Follow me on Twitter at iTalkFortnite. Join the Discord. If you'd like to use me for a supporter creator, my code is iTalkFortnite. Thank you all so much that use my code. Seriously, it does really help me out a lot. Hopefully we get some better item shops soon. And thank you guys so much for watching. And I will catch you all later. See ya.